3 days, So I'm a little bit arted out, so kind of last minute I decide to play some Pokemon tonight. Yeah, should be a good time. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get into it. Okay, so last time, there was a lot of battling wild Pokemon, and it was pretty monotonous and boring, and I did not like doing that on stream. I feel like I just bored a lot of people, so to make up for that, bear with me here. I may have used a quick little cheat code before starting the game today. And I have very good reason for it. Like I said before, last time I streamed this, it was kind of monotonous and boring, because all I was doing was battling wild Pokemon, and I don't mind doing that when I'm, like, playing by myself, but if I'm streaming, I found I don't really like, you know, I just feel like wild Pokemon battles are not as interesting as like actual trainers and gym leaders. But if I'm gonna be using rare candies, there's gonna be rules. There's going to be a level cap, which if you don't know what level cap is, basically my Pokemon cannot be any higher level than the next gym leader's toughest Pokemon's level. So Roxanne's toughest Pokemon is level 15, so I just have to make sure that none of my Pokemon go over level 15 before I go inside the gym. Otherwise, I can't use that Pokemon. So that's the rule to help prevent over-leveling from this much raw rare candy power. So yeah, I have forgotten who's on our team. Okay, Pippi. Okay, so Typhoon is pretty already leveled up. Should be fine. So I just shouldn't... Well, I can battle with him in the gym, like use him against gym trainers and stuff. If he levels up to level 16 while we're inside the gym, that's fine. Should probably go ahead and level up these other guys. Pippi is already there too. Alright. Okay, yeah, he's really close to breaching that level cap, so we try avoid doing any battles outside the gym for now. Let's see. Oh, Magical Leaf, okay. Let's get the rest of these guys to just level 14, just so that we're not pushing the level cap too much. Let's see. Seismic Toss, Absorb, Pursuit. Absorb is not really that useful, I found. So I think we're gonna get rid of that one. Thankfully, we don't have to give guys too many rare candies. They're all pretty close. But, yeah, grinding just takes forever. Oh, right, that guy was already at level 14. Oops. Well, oh well. Oh, headbutt. I'm not sure that's going to be useful for the gym, but oh well. It's this Voltorb. It's going to take a while. Gyms to heal my Pokemon before the actual gym leader, because it would be just too difficult to like go against gym trainers and then the gym leader without being fully healed. All right, let's get into it. Sure, we already battled that guy and her. I think it's oh, that's right. I didn't beat her last time. I remember battling her, but I forgot that I lost to her. Well, shoot, I should have arranged my party before coming in here. Oh well. There we go. course. Yeah, I doubt we're gonna land this. Nah. Switches to the Yanma in this turn. Okay. I was gonna say, if she switched to Yanma in the turn that I send out my grass type, I would have rioted. Oh man. He grows fast. Corsola? That's hard. Maybe just keep Prickly in. I feel like Magical Leaf is gonna do more to it than a electric attack from Bort, yeah. Back to Aeron again. Let's keep him in. Thankfully, this Yanma is pretty much dead. His water gun is doing more damage now than it did the last time I battled her. Alright. Back to the Pokemon Center. Thank you. him in first. That's probably more useful than Gust. I don't think. This is hard to say because, Hoppip is a special attacker, but Gust is like, weaker than in power than Aerial Ace. So I don't know which one would have been better for him. Onyx. Give the starter some more love. I hope he learns some better moves here soon. Thank you. Frost might end up killing Pippi, but this will save Typhoon from losing any experience. He was doing pretty good at the start. Swagger. Journey just to get to the first gym leader.
Definitely do remember
do remember there being a toxic stall in this fight. Probably give somebody the patch of berry. Maybe I should give it to Typhoon. Likely three or four. Okay. Sorry, I am such an oversaver. Your bone club, Kubo. Citrus parry, like, heal him all the way. Wounded tone? might use a ground type move. So maybe send him out. Okay. Use hypnosis. I'm not sure if I have chesto berries. Until I can fully beat. That fort is lasting this long. Oh, there he goes. Oh my god, he actually lived that. Still gonna lose here, but that's still impressive. And he still has his berry juice. It's so sad that was such a waste. Okay. Back up again. Okay. All right, so I need to rearrange some stuff in here. So what I should do is put Prickly first and give it... I do have Cherry Berry. Give him the Cherry Berry. For that Lunatone, don't know if I have a... I don't think I really have a solution to that. I guess prickly would probably be the best because of that, because it has, because that Lunatone has confusion. Wait, is prickly a dark type yet? I actually don't know. No, he's not dark yet. Okay. Yeah, prickly might still be the best option still. So hopefully prickly can kill that Lunatone fast enough to where I can still use him for Lunatone. Let's see. What else did I put on? Did I give this guy an item? Why is it not showing up? Oh, there it is. I'm dumb, or just blind. Alright, so he got berry juice. Maybe I should give this guy a chesto berry. Just in case. I only have one chesto berry. It's gonna be used for this. What did Bort have again? Born berry. Not gonna be. Might have to replace Bort with something else. Because I've never checked to see if anyone else can use this bullet seed. Oh. Uzi is able to. That's surprising. Maybe that'll be useful? Let me check his moves again. Acid, Fire Punch, and Sludge Bomb. I mean, it would probably be nice for him to have a grass move. Just to make him a little more balanced. Yeah. I think I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of Acid. As we can. Oh, it's so So close. I only lost one instead of two this time. I'm going to assume she's gonna send out the Lunatone. He's got a Lumberry. So maybe I should try yawning to put him to sleep so his berry gets wasted. Has items, haha. I'm gonna try yawning him again. This doesn't miss. Might be able to do some decent damage to him. Come on, give me the five. Ah. Let's try him. So I'm pretty sure Bone Club won't even hit this guy because he's got Levitate. Oh, wait, no. Wait, I thought he had... Oh, no, that was Prickly that had Seismic Toss. I'm dumb. Maybe Secret Power will inflict him with a status. Poison him, or I could just try to take him out. I'm pretty sure I've already lost, but I'm just checking to see what stuff works. They're just going to... close. Open that. Go. To make sure there wasn't somebody in there who could be useful. Up to speed with the rest of the team. all the way down here. I'll put him to level 14 for now. Knowledge Bomb. Chance to move. So slowly knocking out her Pokemon. Not with that attitude. I am doing my best to stay optimistic. Deep down, I am crying inside. A way to avoid self-destruct, because it sucks that I can't find out what she sends out after her nose pass self-destructs, because knowing the opponent you're going against is part of strategizing in Pokemon, so I feel like they're kind of taking away that opportunity to strategize and just leaving it up to chance, which I think really sucks. But I don't know if we have anything to deal with that. Mm. real quick. Going back to the Pokemon Center. I'm curious what the Illuminis and Volby can learn. They could know some good moves. What was this guy again? Effect Spore. Basically right at Roxanne, I don't mind making all my guys basically at level 15. Naughty or lowly nature, they're kind of the same. Do again. Just doing a quick Google search on the nature chart. Okay. Naughty nature raises attack and lowers special defense and lonely. They've ordered this so weird on the chart. Oh. Lonely nature ups attack and lowers defense. So yeah, they're basically the same. Seismic toss. most surprising Pokemon are learning Seismic Toss in this game. Sonic Boom. Sonic Boom does... It always inflicts 20. That could be useful. Pippi is kind of in danger because he's part flying type, so that doesn't really help his case very much. Will not be the end for Pippi. If we win in the gym, he's gonna go back into the party. But for right now, we just have to think about what is best for winning. Somebody else in here have? Oh yeah, he had a. Berry juice. Okay. take back that cherry berry and give him something else. He also has cherry berry. Maybe give him one of the healing items. I think he's still the best one to go against the Lunatone. Maybe Bort could handle it. Let's see here. Prickly Orin Berry. That lily. Surviving by the time Lily comes out, then it might be fine. Let's see. Just try to seismic toss. Ooh, just quite a bit, actually. could be it. This could be it. Yes! First time that's happened this whole stream. it was Lily. I think I might just keep Illuminese in. I don't think I can use it for anything else later. Just with how low her HP is and she's paralyzed, so I might as well just do try to land a Thunder Wave and hope for a clean switch. Yeah. Well. Okay. Let's see. Maybe send out Uzi. Yes, poison. I mean, he's gonna recover, but he can only do that for so long. Oh my god, Roxanne, just accept it. would do much for it. Doing so much to him, but it's just not enough. It is possible to kill this thing. We've confirmed that here today. NRF? Yeah, he definitely should not be out here for that. Was a healing item. Close with that one. Closer than we've ever gotten. So I think we're on the right track. What did I give? Oh, I gave him a peck berry, that's right. So I think I was gonna put him up against the toxic stall later, but I'm starting to think that, maybe Uzi should go against that. I'm just so nervous that he's gonna use self-destruct. Oh, please no. Oh, thank goodness. Okay. Alright. The little leaf is coming out. This guy, he's almost dead, but seismic toss might be the best thing for finishing off that lily, though. Does run the risk of using ancient power. Thank you. finally stop using recover. God. Stalls with a passion. Oh, finally. Lunatone. Yes. Doing Bort against the Lunatone. Maybe I should have Prickly be the one. I feel like Prickly could use a Berry Juice. We're doing pretty good. Thank you. I do like that this Teddy Ursa has, Faint Attack and Lick. But... Pokemon combinations in hopes that something will work. Holding berry juices in the PC. I feel like I had more than... Oh, right. He still has his... got put back all the way in the bottom. Ah. Oh well, someone was still holding a berry juice I needed to get back anyway, so... Alright. I think there's enough time for... two more attempts, I think. If we don't get it after two more tries, I'm gonna have to call it a night, unfortunately. I really want to beat Roxanne in this stream. Wouldn't it just be, like, amazing if I beat her, like, on the very last try of the day? Okay. One's item up. Yes. Say screw it and start over, because I feel like this try is already doomed. I could take an educated guess what she might send out. Maybe it'll be the Lunatone. It's either the Lunatone or the Lily. seems to be her pattern. I guess she sent out the Anorith before, too. That she might recover, but there's a chance she can use any of her three super effective moves against my guys here. Okay. I feel like... Illumines getting stopped by paralysis twice kind of costed me that fight. Other than that, I think we don't really need to change anything. All right, this guy still has Fetch a Berry. I thought Kubo would be high enough in defense to withstand those attacks from Anorith, but it's just not enough, unfortunately. I might try once more with Kubo in the party. And if he doesn't work a second time, then I'll just have to replace him with somebody else. Thank you. Okay. It's good to see that guy taken down. This feels like another kind of grind. What? Critical hit? Are you kidding me? Is it citrus berry? One more try against this Anorith. Okay. Oh, is that a Lum Fairy? Yeah. Ugh. I had a ray of hope for, like, for a couple of seconds. Oh, and she withdraws, of course. Ooh, second time. But I probably shouldn't be leaving Kubo out with this guy. I don't know if Board is gonna be able to handle the relic hand. I don't know what would be better against him. Try Shockwave and see how much damage that does. Ooh, does quite a bit. Okay. Unfortunately, I couldn't beat Roxanne today. Yeah, I feel like at this point I'm just getting unlucky rolls when it comes to status infliction stuff. Definitely need to think of something with very high attack. I can do some high stab moves, but yeah, I'll have to give that some thought. But yeah, I think I'm just going to call it a night here. But yeah, I just want to say thank you to everyone who tuned in tonight, and I hope you enjoyed the stream. I'll be back tomorrow. I will most likely be drawing something. I think by tomorrow I will have, I'll be, rejuvenated in, my art rut. Hopefully. When you get into an art rut, it's kind of hard to predict when they go away, but, Oh, yeah, it was fun to watch. Have a good night. Thank you. I hope you all have a good night. And I will see you tomorrow.